Ah, Factorio. You probably don't need me to explain what this game is, but I've been putting it off playing it for years. Now, before I show you what I've been working on, a big thanks to the devs for a key to this game. They just released 1.0, and they're very proud of it. If you haven't checked it out before, now's a really good time to check this game out. Welcome to my factory. Everything about it is fully automated. This is only the tutorial factory, but I've spent about 10 hours working on this one alone. I want to show you how it works. We start here with the coal. The coal is carried on this conveyor belt. This conveyor belt goes underground, and that leads to our boilers. Our boilers have a mind of their own. They pump steam to these steam engines, and then the steam engines pump power to everything else. It depends on itself because the steam engines actually keep the coal burning and coming, so eventually I'll need to do something there. It's not fully automated, but it's pretty close. We also need the coal to power everything else. These machines mine iron. Iron and, well, we used to have stone. When the iron and the coal get to this path, a bunch of arms reach out and grab them and put them in these ovens for smelting. When they're smelted, they're developed into more complex materials like iron plates. Those iron plates are then taken out and made into even more complex materials. Then it goes on an elaborate series of assemblers, and then that eventually leads to research and more science. It was kind of a mess because I didn't unlock the later power lines, but that's pretty much the way it works, is just that everything is a mess until you unlock later technologies. I don't think I could put this game down though, and it's probably one of the more amazing games I've played. Plus, the graphics kind of bring me back to The Sims. I don't know if that's such a far comparison, but it's incredibly satisfying seeing everything automated and grow. So I figure, why start with something this complex? It's pretty generic too. It's just the tutorial one. Oh, I forgot to show you my train. My train is over here. It unloads iron from this other site. We'll see if, no, it's gonna be a while. Hop in my car. Now my car takes me anywhere. It doesn't care. It's a car. But if we follow these power lines long enough, we end up at Resource Bay number 2. And it has now mined all of the iron. Iron there, okay. Well, it's literally chock full of iron. Looks like we need another chest here, but that's fine. We'll just build one up. Show you a little bit of arm action. Get that iron in that box. Now, you could probably see how a lot of this game could suck you in and make this work. But I figure let's start our own factory from scratch, shall we? Now, since this is kind of a game showcase, I mean, I've never played Factorio before this, but there's a lot of different game modes. There's like multiplayer, there's all kinds of stuff you can do. We're gonna do free play. The intended way of play. We're coloring in the lines here today, and our ship has crashed on a planet. Now, I'm the sole survivor and engineer. The main goal is to launch a rocket into space, but to me, the real goal is... To me, the real goal, as in many things in life, is just automation. We start out on a random map like this. Now, the irony is, we could do everything on our own, you know? I don't need the machines. Well, I'd need the machines, but as in most things in life, you'll spend your entire life making efforts to do nothing, which just means at first you have to do something in order to get to the nothing part. So like my grandfathers before me, I'll mine for iron. We start with the four elements: copper, iron, stone, coal. Now if we want something to do anything, we'll need this stone furnace, so we'll need stone. Let's mine stone out of the ground. Literally 5 stones were all we needed to make a stone furnace. But what's the point of life if you're forced into harsh servitude and labor all the time? Now if we want to get all of this, we have to start with some of these. The world is incredibly large. But we'll just start off with a stone factory to get more stone. Now before we get the wonders of electricity, we need to use coal and whale oil, so we'll start there. Unfortunately, we do need to manually take the coal out of the ground to start. Now, you can see how most of this process works. I get the burners and I get the coal, and this all takes an alarmingly long period of time, but it's incredibly engaging. So I'm just gonna speed this process up for you. We can use coal machines to get more coal and put the coal back in them. Right now, though, we need to keep manually resupplying them, which isn't very much fun. Now we have 1 drill on each of the resources. And like my ancestors, I can't depend on coal production forever. So instead, we're going to get a boiler and a steam engine right away. This is going to give us power and actually make our lives not ass. Because right now, I have to literally jog back and forth from machine to machine. What's brilliant is that Factorio actually makes you experience labor and childbirth. every moment decreasing your desire to work with your hands. Ah, finally, we have a steam engine. But that's not all, we're not done. We need an offshore pump. And to make that, I needed to make this computer chip by hand. Now I can make an offshore pump and several pipes to connect them. We have everything we need. Glorious. We could just put that into our inventory. Glorious. And I guess we'll just use the nearest available body of water. Well, on the other hand, we do have more natives over here. I'm ready for a fight. I'm not ready for a fight, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Pump the water. Pipe over the water. The water needs water. Start with this thing. Chop these down. Choppity chop. Chop chop. Put that in that, and then put this in here, and I think we've got power. Build this wooden pole. And yeah, we are now officially have power. We need to manually refuel this though, so we want to change that ASAP. Now I'm going to embark on a series of long conveyor belts. We can get electric mining drills and we need to tie all of this to all of that. Because this just isn't working. There's too much running involved. Now, like in real life, we'll start out by building a miner and connecting these power lines. Gone are the days of coal. We can put this now right here. We still need to walk back and forth to supply the coal. Now, this thing is working on electricity. But we're also making more noise, and that could rile up the natives. So we embark on an increasingly convoluted quest to hit rocks. Now we begin with a conveyor belt. Take this shit apart. Now we've triggered an alien attack by pollution. Okay, now we bring out the small gun. Literally, I have only one gun. We have enough to buy an arm. A beautiful arm. This can put this into this. And we can put this on this. Now we should start to see the glory of coal mining coming to fruition. And there we go, the coal is being pooped onto the belt. There, now we have automated, well, almost automated power. As soon as we actually make this into an electric drill and then link it back up with more power lines, then it'll actually be automated power. Oh, more bad people. Now we replace this with this and put these here. And we can just link this back to our power grid. And with this, we've taken ourselves off of the glory of coal. Now we can actually start to set up automation, which is what this game is all about. Start small, then end tall. We can get rid of our ovens and replace them with exactly the same ovens. We just need some inserters. And now these things pick this stuff up and put them in here. The one problem is we still need to refuel by hand. Ultimately, we're going to need to research. Because if we don't, we'll still be just trapped in the Dark Ages forever. This machine produces science. Science and thinking. And since we haven't unlocked an assembler, I need to produce knowledge by hand. Now, if we want to get a long-armed inserter, we need automation. And so we'll begin the research. This will make it so that it's not a living hell to run our ovens anymore. Though I'm being attacked, which will be a common theme here, and I'd better not run out of bullets, because they can actually do a shitload of damage. We finished the research. Now again, as in real life, the more you put into it, the more people expect of you. But before I go any further, I have one festering problem that keeps getting worse. And if I leave it for much longer, I might actually die. So I'm going to try to slowly attract them over here. Okay, that's a start, yeah. But I actually have no defenses right now other than my own body. If we can, it would be good to just wipe out this entire nest. I think my health can afford it right now. So we'll just take them out bit by bit. From here, and three left. They will keep respawning like the Zerg, but if I'm gonna keep upping production, then I have to handle this problem right now or later. And if I handle it later, it'll get much, much worse. Now, it's pretty bad. I don't wanna give you the idea that it's- Fuck! I died. Well, that's a first. I guess I just lose everything. That's also like in real life. Okay. Well, I can get used to that. Do they at least? Okay, more at the nest. We're going to need to come in with heavier firepower if we want to fight these guys, because I can't keep fending off waves like this. Well, I can. It'll just get increasingly terrible. Again. This is why I need them to stop ruining my life. They're back again. Here comes another one. I may not be enough to stop them this time. I built new armor, but all right, We may survive without needing weapons. Yeah, good, good. Knowledge. We've acquired so much of it. I bit off more of the nest. And we actually managed it. Now with this light armor, we might actually be able to put a dent in this thing. And nope, we cannot. We definitely cannot. At least not at this state. We're all set up for the creation of science. And then we can take that science and bring it over here. And voila, the science is happening now. We're researching at a faster rate. We've got everything going in assembly line. And obviously we'll have to make this setup more versatile, but right now it's actually working pretty well, you know? We have arms transferring our science, but they keep destroying all of my shit. And it's actually going to come to a point where I can't ignore it anymore. Our next project will be extremely complex. If we want energy, better electric energy, which means we can actually refuel all of our ovens, we're going to need green science. Unfortunately, it takes an extremely long time to produce green science. And I don't want to have to do it all by hand, because then I'll just be sitting here, so it pretty much, if you do it by hand, it would take the same amount of time as building an automated machine to do it. And like in real life, we're limited again by the number of arms that we have. Now somehow we can combine all of that and then get a robot arm from this. Now with transport belts and robot arms, I'm going to be able to create green science. And when I have green science, then I can get more stuff. And then I'm going to actually need a military. And they're destroying everything! Well, fortunately, they don't attack the more complex systems. They attack only the miners to start. That's the bright side. When you have only a pistol and no military research. Yeah, but we can't keep on expanding our economy forever, or everything will just blow up. They tend to do that. Science being moved from thing to thing. I've got a lot of resources. I'm gonna start boxing the ones that are extra. It's impossible. To figure, well, it's not impossible, but it's very hard to figure out all of the exact ratios, and I don't like looking it up. I prefer discovering it for myself. I may have bitten off more than I had wagered. Please survive. Please survive. Please survive. No. Okay. This is Factorio. Struggle. Constantly. Now we've created 9 labs in all seriousness. We've gotten a really long way with our research. We're actually further ahead of where we were before. It's set up more like my imagination would want it to be. It's still not perfect. I mean, we'll unlock new tools, and that pretty much makes everything that you've already done obsolete. But for the most part, this is what I wanted to do. I wanted to set up some basic factory, you know? We mine the resources, we put them in ovens. It's almost perfect, except that we have these things, which we need better power lines to get. Well, we could do it without that, but still, it's just not the same. We assemble stuff here. That gets made into new inputs, and then those inputs stay inputs and become new outputs, which become new inputs in here, and then become new outputs over here, and then new inputs over here, and then new inputs over here. But ultimately, I spend a lot of time just grinding behind the scenes and making the bugs go away. But in general, this is a fabulous game, although I'm not a game reviewer. If I were reviewing this game, I'd give it a 10 out of 10 for engrossment. When I play this game, I'm completely immersed in it. And although it takes me a long time to research some of the technologies, I think that's just mostly because I'm bad at it. And it's okay to be bad at it. Oh shit, there are more now. They could potentially wipe out my entire base. Okay, lead them away. Fuck. I did not expect that. Okay. Alright, so the infinite respawn isn't actually, so OP as I thought it was. It's still good, but at least they aren't hitting important shit. Ah, man, right when we were just about to get the electricity. So close, yet so far. Well, we do have electric energy distribution now. And last but not least, an actual military. Well, looking back, I could have made my life incredibly much so easier. It turns out I could have made an SMG really easily the entire time. Alright, well, at least we get to see the firepower. Let's just make sure we have enough. Okay, now for the moment of satisfaction we've all been waiting for. We could just SMG them all Oh, they're still getting to me, but I will probably win this time. Probably. I hope. Okay, yeah. There's still way too much over there, but I think we can come at it once I get back up to full health. At the very least, I can get my revenge. And if those larvae thing to. Okay. There is some mechanic. There's dodging, I guess. Just the right amount. Can I stay far enough away to. Yep. Just gonna stand over here where you can't hit me. Good. It's a Terran rush versus Zerg. And one nest is down. Good. Goodbye. We could just take out the rest of this. Okay. Nope, we can't do that. Oh, we can dodge. We can dodge. I still have my feet. They can't take those away. But I can run out of ammo. I'm very bad at Factorio, but you should still play it. I think I'm good with the setting up and the resource part, but when it comes to bringing together the military and the resources, I think we could take this base down with a pistol, though. Just barely. And 3, 2, 1, go.
Yep.
Well, I may have been spit by acid, but at least they aren't spawning anymore near my base, and I can go on in peace while I get the basic automations underway. After that, I think we start to rile up more of them, and then they come from even further around, so... yeah, that probably won't be very pleasant, but we've got our basic stuff set up. I'm struggling for different scenarios I could do here. A lot of the stuff that I do is just very meme-y and crazy, but I'd like to kind of open it up to more variety, so I'm trying out a few games. Factorio is definitely high on the list, and there's even more I want to cover too. But for now, Factorio's hit 1.0, you should definitely check it out. Anyway, once again, I hope you enjoyed. As always, my name's Ambiguous Amphibian, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.